welcome to First State Airgun. I'm your host, Lou, and today we're going to be checking out H&N Baracuda Hunters 10.49 grains in 177 caliber. We're going to be using two guns today. I'll explain that a little bit more as the video progresses. You'll see why. So we're going to keep this short and sweet and get right to the testing. First up, out of the Umarex Synergis, is going to be the chronograph. Let's check it out. These numbers are not very good. They should be generating around 13.5 to 14 foot-pounds of muzzle energy. Well, for chronograph numbers out of the Umarex Synergis, that was utterly pathetic. So, let's try something else. I want to make sure that the gun is working right, right? So, what did I do? I took a 7.4 grain pellet. I'll bring this up here.
Shot your standard 7.4 grain Crossman Premier. Got 912 feet per second. 13.67 foot-pounds of muzzle energy. Right where it should be.
As you can see, the Umarex Synergis with the Crossman Premier was getting acceptable numbers. But with the Baracuda Hunters, just couldn't shoot them with enough foot-pounds of energy, in my opinion. That's why I think a chronograph is essential for a serious air gunner. We'll get to that at the end of the video here. So, what I wanted to do, I was going back in my memory banks, and the TPR 1200 is a hard-hitting gun. So, I think it has enough oomph to push these 10.49 grains. So, guess what happens?
Just as I suspected, 772 feet per second, 13.89 foot-pounds of muzzle energy out of the TPR 1200. Very respectable. I think that has something to do with the pellet head size affecting each gun differently. This is our 10-yard accuracy test. Shot with the Umarex Synergis. Ended up being a fairly decent group, even though it was shooting with a such low feet per second. Let's take a closer look here at the group. As you can see, had one really good flyer there, but you can cover just about up. Oh, there you go. You can cover up the whole group with a Corona Extra bottle cap. Not a paid promotion.
So that's why we're using two guns. The Umarex Synergis shot the pellets accurately, no doubt, but certainly not enough foot-pounds of energy for anything serious. You could do a little hunting, but I just wouldn't trust it. Now the TPR 1200, we're going to use that bad boy's testing here for the Baracudas. So let's get to it. Let's get these bad boys into some gel. You know what time it is. It's my favorite time. It's time to shoot some clay.
Excellent expansion. Center is our test pellet. Left is gel only. Right is clay into gel. As you can see, even in gel only, started to expand. Clay definitely did it.
Those H&N Baracudas definitely hit hard. Even got expansion in the gel and through the clay. Really, really nice expansion. 10-yard accuracy, no problemo. So we're definitely going to stretch these bad boys out to 25, maybe a little bit before we get outdoors to do that on film. I can go to the gun range and do it, but not allowed to film anything, and we need proof in the pudding. A couple other things I just want to touch on real quick. The importance of a chronograph. and testing pellets out of your air gun. As you saw, the Umarex Synergis shot the 7.4 grain premieres, no problemo, 13.6 foot-pounds of muzzle energy. The Baracuda Hunters didn't do so well. I don't think it had anything to do with the weight. I think it has more to do with pellet size, pellet skirt size, barrel twist, and chamber size. All the manufacturers, pellet manufacturers, millionths of a millimeter could make the difference between shooting good and not shooting good. So you definitely need to test pellets out of your gun for accuracy and chronograph them so you know what kind of power you get. Because if I assumed that those Baracuda Hunters were putting out 13, 14 foot-pounds of muzzle energy, I was mistaken. So you gotta test. That's the importance of testing. So that being said, we're gonna test those Baracuda Hunters at 25 yards, hopefully in the future. Buddy, have a great day, stay safe, and I'll catch you all next time.